Pilgrim's Pitch. Cool. All right, Foo. We were just doing the door and having a beer, and then a local musician, Joe, turned up. Joe is going to tell you about his acoustic night, where it is and stuff, and then give us a little tune, because that's what we do. Yeah, so I hope you're getting the idea of what we're doing now a bit better, and I'll pass it over to Joe.
So, yeah. Hello, my duckies. My name's Joe B. I host an open microphone even on at the Black Friar in Newcastle under Lyme every Tuesday night from 9 PM onwards. Come play, get a free drink. This one's called The Lodger. My landlady had three lovely daughters. They used to come and make my bed each day. They used to come and clean my living quarters, but their mother ain't quite sure they didn't stay. There was Mary, she seemed cheery, and there was Helen, she seemed well and truly skeptical about my qualities. There was Julie, she was truly well proportioned, but her caution brought exhaustion on my aching arteries. But I was wrong, they weren't at all impervious to the possibilities of high romance, and I sensed a certain girlish nervousness in the way they folded my pajama pants. And I was right, for late one night with little Mary, like a fairy as I lay sleeping, came a creeping to my side. She was mine, it was divine, but we were doomed. Very soon into the room came sister Helen, and she cried, Mary, go to bed, off Mary went. Now, young man, Helen said, for your punishment, we mustn't have a fight, we mustn't make a row, turn off the light. It's my turn now. Well, after all, I'm young and relatively vigorous, though I still protest my innocence. By temperament, I'm strictly unpolygamous, and if I sinned, I sinned in self-defense. Nevertheless, I must confess, I wouldn't miss that sort of bliss, and when it ended, I was rendered comatose. When loud and clear, very near, in my ear, a loud voice spoke, and I was awoken from my post-coital doze. Helen, go to bed. Helen went away. Now, young man, Julie said, you will have to pay. You blighted Helen's charms, filched her purity. Open up your arms, come and filch me. Really rather tired. I thought I'd given all that I could give. The little kid was all that I desired. But I'm British, so my upper lip was stiff. She was chaotic, idiotic, quite exotic, and ecstatic, acrobatic, and emphatically fine. All to no good, but when I could open my eyes to my surprise, I found her mother looking into mine. Surely go. Julie left the scene. Now, listen, Mom, I said, and on the old routine, I'll do what you like, but I shall be vexed, and I'll bloody well go on strike. If grandma's next time,